Today, I want to talk about demons. Yes, we are going to get into demonology today. We are going to talk about the left-hand path, because there is definitely a lot of misunderstandings revolving around this subject here. Today, when we speak of demonology, we make reference to the Goetia, or the Lesser Keys of Solomon. I would say it's a little deeper than that, because most people who have been introduced to Goetia, they never looked into Kabbalah, its origin. Now, as a quote-unquote Christian, I want to talk today from an experiential perspective as well as a theoretical perspective. When we speak of the left-hand path and Vodou, we have Pitwo and we have Rada, two different rites. But we find that when we talk about Pitwo, we are leaning more towards the left. And when we talk about Rada, we're leaning more towards the right. Which brings us to the Sephira of Kabbalah. We find the same principle. When we look at the tree of life, the blueprint for the cosmos, as well as the psychology of man and woman, we find that there is a pillar of severity and there is a pillar of mercy. And then there is a pillar of equilibrium. In this, the left and right pillar has been considered as the extremes, where when one goes too far to the left, they find themselves in severity, aggression, just like in Vodou. We can say also, or rather say, I can say that in Vodou, you find the same. In Rada, you find Ogu. But now in Pitwo, you find Ogu Zirwuj. You find Ezreli in Rada. Now when you go into Pitwo, you find Ezreli Zirwuj. A manifestation of the same force, but a different, but a difference in occupation. Now, the forces, or what they call the Sephira, are the manifest or the animations of Ein Sof, or the nothingness. Now, when you are understanding this blueprint, you have to look at it as a descension from the eternity, from eternity into what we call the world of matter, or the world of motion, or what the Jews refer to as Asiya. Asiya, some people may pronounce it as that. Now, understanding the Goetia, the Klipoth, theoretically, you have a Lurianic Kabbalic perspective that in the beginning, Ein Sof, Ein Sof descended or started to create himself to experience life. In this process, there was a dissension that occurred, which had a catastrophe that the lower vessels from the fourth sphere to the tenth were not able to maintain, or rather say the fourth to the ninth, were not able to maintain the power of Ayin. And this caused the breaking or the shattering of the Sheroth. And this is from this perspective, because there's many perspectives in Kabbalah. So these broken shards fell into what they call Malkuth, or the world of Asiya, that is governed by Malkuth. We have the earthly realm, but we also have shards from the prior creation that fell into our world. And this is where we find the dissension. We find, you know, human beings leering to the left at times and then leering toward the right. When When we're talking about the world of demons, we have to look at it as when, you know, that this is a reality. When you look at the image of Anima Sola, they say that is the purgatory. Some may even refer to it as hell. When you look at all those, when you have a vision, when you're taken into vision, when you are working with that spirit, also referred to as the tranquil spirit or Mama Lugawu, you find that when you descend into that realm, you meet all these people that are not upright. They have a lot of vices. They have a lot of issues. So we have a perspective that there is a world that exists that is not perfect outside of our world. But we have to take into consideration, if we are looking at it from a Kabbalistic perspective, is that in our world, there is a shadow world. And in this shadow world, it has an influence on our world. You cannot be a practicing black magician, a black magician. You cannot be a quote-unquote black magician and not understand this process. Even as a voodooism. A voodooism also notes that in voodoo, there is a dark side and there is a light side. And these two forces are a manifestation of the same force. Again, from the Lurianic perspective, this is just one perspective. There are many more. And that's for you to do your diligent research into Kabbalah to understand that there's more than one view of how evil came into the world, because you'll find the pillars. The pillars in Kabbalah, in one perspective, they'll say that the pillars are the reasons why there is evil in the world. This eliminates the concepts of the breaking of the vessels, where per se it is human beings who choose to do right or to do wrong. They can go left or they can go right. Just like in voodoo, Ezreli Donto or Ezreli Freda, the extreme manifestation of them is Ezreli Zyewuj. From a voodoo perspective, Ezreli Zyewuj is just Ezreli Freda or Ezreli Donto when she goes into rage. So when we look at the Sirah, the Sephirah, we see the same. When you lean too much on the left, all that represents mercy goes to the extreme and we find war, we find bloodshed, we find violence. Ultimately, when you even look, I'm going to stray away from this for a bit. When you go into Anton LaVey's book, I believe his book that he wrote about Satanism, you find in there that they give reference to deities that are considered demons. Now, you find a lot of deities from voodoo, such as Dumbala, listed in that book as being demons. So you have to say to yourself, how is Dumbala a demon, but in voodoo, he's considered Rada, a very positive spirit? So when you get into demonology, you have to understand that what the references to those we call demons at one point in time were not considered demons. So you have to understand that labels are created by human beings. A deity that was considered a high esteem at one point in time has become labeled as a malevolent force that is no good. When you are a practicing occultist, you begin to see that the concept of good and evil does not exist. The concept of demons and angels do not exist, because a demon is no more. A demon can be a good angel, but the angel can basically do evil as well. That's why they'll say in Haitian culture that Saint Michael or Saint Michael is not what we think Saint Michael, you know, is. Saint Michael is not just this benevolent saint. Saint Michael can cause a lot of hellfire, bring a lot of war and destruction. And this is the same energy that we find on the left pillar in Kabbalah. So, this is just my take on demonology and the left-hand path. I hope this video is very informative. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.